Welcome back, dear friends. How are you? Hope you all are well by the grace of Almighty Allah. And I am also well. Welcome you all to our online place, Rautan IJ Mitra Online School. Before starting the class, I would like to introduce myself. I am Luzbun Nahar, Assistant Teacher, Rautan IJ Mitra Institution, Rautan, Chattogram. So, what is our today's lessons? Our today's lessons is thanks for your work. Our today's learning outcome is talk about people, places and familiar objects. After completing the lesson, students will be able to talk about people, places and familiar objects in short. Ask and answer questions, write short paragraph, participate in short dialogues. In my last class, I have discussed about the lessons thanks for your work, and I have given you some homeworks related to the text, and I have given you 3 questions. What time does Budul wake up? Where do the people of Shankar put their rubbish? What happened when Bulbul became 6? And the students of class 6, I hope you have done your homework in the home. And today you will match the answer that you have write down in your home. What time does Bulbul wake up? Bulbul wakes up in 5 o'clock. In the lessons, we have find that Bulbul wakes up in 5 o'clock. Where do the people of Shankar put their rubbish? People of Shankar put their rubbish in plastic bins and leave them in front of their house. What happened when Bulbul became sick? When Bulbul became sick, the people of Shankar got piles of rubbish in front of their house and the whole area became dirty and unhygienic. So the people of Shankar became falls in great troubles when Bulbul became sick. What will happen if Bulbul falls sick again? If Bulbul falls sick again, the whole area will turn into a big dustbin. The whole area will become dirty and unhygienic. So, Bulbul mentions in the text that if he will fall sick again, if even for a few days, the whole area will become a big dustbin. What will you say to Bulbul if you meet him? I have given the question to you. What will you will say if you say to Bulbul if you meet him? Okay. I will tell him that if I meet Bulbul, then I will thank him for his great service and I wish him long life so that he can serve the area for more years. So from these lessons, you have find 5 questions related to the text. I hope you will find out the answers from the text you have read out. Okay, so in number B2, you have to make a composition on a person who do the service like bulbul. Think of a person who helps you live well. As bulbul helps the people of Shankar area to live well and hygiene, you also think of a person who helps you to live you well. Write a composition on this person. Now answer the following question. So you have to write down the answers to make the composition of a person who help you to live well. What does he or she do? How does his work help you live well? What time does he start his work? How does he do the work? Does he like the job? Why or why not? What will happen if he stop working? What do you think about his job? Okay, in the text you have find some different rules of grammar. So we will discuss the lines in here. Notice the verbs, and this is about language focus. Notice the verb in the italics in the following sentence. Bulbul collects rubbish from the Shankar area in Dhaka. Every day he walks up at 5 o'clock and walks along the streets. So you have to see the italic words in verbs. So you have to see the verbs of this sentence. Collects works. So you have seen that there is a S or ES added with the verb. We talk about usual routines in simple present tense. In simple present tense, the verb takes an S or ES if the subject is any one person, he, she, etc. So in simple present tense, there is a rule that if the verb is third person singular number, then you have to put S or ES with the verb, with the main verb. So the rules of simple present tense is included in the text. As in the text you have find that the sentences are of simple present tense and simple past tense, then we will see the rules of simple past tense. Notice the verb in the following sentence in italics. So there is a rules that if the subject is third person singular number, then the verb will attest with S or ES. S or ES. You have to add S or ES with the verb. And if in this sentence there are different rules. Notice the verb in the following sentence in italics. The people in Shankar area become very upset. So the people in Shankar area became very upset. So you have to notice the word became. Become, became, become. So they got piles of rubbish waiting outside their house. Here got. Get, got. So all the sentence here talk about the first. So they are in simple past tense. In simple past tense, the verb is always in its first form, just like got, became. So the present look. There are two type of sentence, and they are simple present tense and simple past tense. two words like collect and walk. So you have to put S or ES with the words and so if the subject is third person singular number just like Bulbul collects rubbish from the Shankar area in Dhaka. Here Bulbul is the third person singular number, one person, only one person, then the verb have to add S or ES. In simple first tense, the people in Shankar area became very upset. They got piles of rubbish waiting in outside their house. So here got, get, got, and become became. So the first form of become and get, got and first, we find that simple first tense have the first form of verb. Okay, so we already finished the lessons in our two classes. Okay, in the last classes we have discussed about the main text and simple short questions, and in today's class we have discussed about the questions, main questions, and the language focus and grammar part related to the text. I hope you enjoy the class and you will learn more about the lessons in your home. Until our next class, stay in your home and stay safe. Allah Hafiz.